Hello, welcome back to my channel. I'm Ken, and today we are going to be talking about this learning style, which is called VAK learning style, where some people just call it VAK in short. So what does this learning style stand for and why is it important? So let me just explain what is it first, and then I'll explain with examples why is it important to identify this learning style and to make sure that whatever training that you do or how you're going to suit your training style to suit all these three people, these three kind of people with these three different learning style. That is if you're a trainer. But it's good for you yourself to know that what's your learning style as well, so that you can be able to identify which learning style that fits you better. Then you can find the trainer or whichever courses that's related more to more related towards that learning style that suits you, so that you have better impact to what you learn. Okay, let me explain first. So VAK, as what I mentioned, it stands for letter V, A and K. So V stands for visual. So what does visual mean? Visual means the learning style of seeing and reading. So for people that like visual style kind of learning, there'll be a lot of how to say modules, diagram, graph, PowerPoints, all the thing, everything will be displayed presentation side, this presentation wise. So some people like to learn through that and they find it more effective by seeing. So that's why it's called visual. So when they learn by visual, they'll be able to learn faster. So this is the visual kind. So A is auditory. Auditory is those that's on listening and speaking. Those that will learn better and learn faster through these two methods. And it tends to give them, they tend to learn faster through whatever that's being said. How is it being said? The story to entice them. Less of visual, because maybe sometimes they just get bored looking at visuals. So, of course, for example, some trainers, they just depend on a lot of visual, but their tone are very monotonous. So these people does not attract those people that are auditory learners. Auditory learners need people that can use really the power of storytelling, use the power of doing pauses, hand gestures, because it all depends on how the words is being said and mentioned, and that is how some people learn. That's the big difference between visual and auditory. The next learning style is the K style, which is kinesthetic. So kinesthetic are learning style where they have touching and doing. So basically what they do is they learn by doing it, and that's why you see a lot of courses, they have a lot of those examples, those workshop, workbook, where you have to do something, you have to write something, and you have to like group activity, games. This is to entice people that is in kinesthetic learning portion, learning styles, because they learn by doing. Some people, they see, they also get bored. Listen, also cannot attentive. But when they do, they learn. So even when you are in secondary school, primary school, or high school, middle school, whichever school you name it, those below teenagers, you notice that some training methods, especially, you notice that some students will get, how to say, get alienated, get isolated, People that feel isolated usually are people that like to have kinesthetic learning style, because the conventional learning is a lot of visual and auditory, where they use a board or now maybe use slides or whatsoever, and it depends on the words that's being spoken by the teacher or the lecturer, and some people can't even really train in an attractive manner, which is important for auditory learning. And those kinesthetic, they like to do things, they like to learn by doing, and if you do not incorporate them in your class, in your training, you will definitely lose them out. And that's why a good training module will tend to, I know some people say you have to be focused, but if you can combine these three into your learning, it will not only make it that everyone can learn, but also make it fun as well. I mean, visual learn something from auditory, auditory learn something from kinesthetic, because it's fun as well. You won't be so monotonous, and the training will be more effective to people as well. Comparing, you just focus on visual, auditory. So one of the top trainers, they will usually incorporate a bit of slides, a bit of diagram to entice people that is visual learning style. Auditory, they use a lot of words, stories, pauses, and how to really use emotions using words to get them be attracted to what they are teaching. And they will always be like a workshop kind of matter where they have to do it, whether they have to form a design on the spot or have group activities where there's a challenge they have to do to complete. And it will bring a more holistic kind of experience for everyone that participate in this in the training. And it's good for you to know yourself as well, which one that you like. For example, whether you're a visual, auditory, or kinesthetic guy, so that at least you know that when you go there, you know which one you can focus on and learn to enjoy what other people are doing using other senses as well. Because learning from one sense alone can get a bit monotonous and boring, although it is your strength. However, it is always good to be able to have many, many kind of different learning styles to make it so you can get out of your comfort zone and do something different. So this is my opinion on it. And hopefully you learn a bit about this VAK learning style and how you can use it into your training system if you're a trainer, or how you can maybe advise some or trainer friends you have, you know, or maybe you yourself are giving training, or maybe knowing your style. Because most of people is within these three categories, whether they are visual, they're auditory, or kinesthetic. So it's VAK. Hopefully this information is valuable to you, and if you like what I share, do like my video. If you have any comment, anything you want to say, any comments, anything at all, just feel free to comment in the comment section below. And please subscribe to my channel so that I can share more content like this to you. And I see you in my next video. Bye bye.